Hello friends, on today's tutorial we want to look at the thumb rule and how we are going to calculate the quantity of steel for the slab, beam, column and footing using this thumb rule. Sometimes we have to act quickly to move on since we cannot calculate everything in the field, and that is why you find that every profession has set and maintained a certain thumb rule, so that we can be able to get approximate values that we can use when we are in the field. So I want to look at the thumb rule and how we are going to apply it in calculating the quantity of steel for those structural members. So welcome back again to my YouTube channel. If you are new here, you know how we do it. Kindly subscribe, share, and don't forget to leave a comment. And I cannot forget to thank you guys for the support that you've shown. Let's start by defining what is this thumb rule that you are going to use in getting our quantity of steel. It's approximate value. So it does not give exact value, but it's a value that we can work on depending on some factors that have been laid. So structural members that you want to look at and the percentage of steel that we are going to use. So we are going to start with the slab. The slab is 1% of the total volume of concrete. We have the beam is 2% of the total volume of concrete. Column is 2.5 of the total volume of concrete. And then for the footing is 0.8% of the total volume of concrete. So what it means? It means that we are going to first calculate the volume of concrete, and what we have as the volume of concrete, a certain percent of it, we are going to use it to calculate the quantity of steel. So that is what we are going to do. So we are going to take an example. We are going to take an example, say for the slab, get the volume, and then see how we are going to proceed to calculate the quantity of the steel in that slab. Let's proceed. We are using a slab. This is our slab here. We have a length of 6 meters, a width of 4 meters, and the depth is 0.15 meters. Now, the first thing that we need to do, we need to calculate the volume of the concrete in the slab. So that is the length times the width times the depth. That is, sorry, this is 6 times 4 times 0.15, giving us 3.6. If you tabulate, that is 3.6 meter cubic. Now, we said for us to estimate the quantity of steel, it's 1% of the volume of concrete in the slab. Now, the volume is 3.6 cubic meters. 1%, that is 0.01, times the volume, that is 3.6, giving us 0.036. cubic meters. Now that is the volume of steel in 3.6 cubic meter concrete. Now this is what we have is volume, but we need to find the quantity of steel. The density of steel, okay, for this is 7850. It's around, it ranges from 7000 to, yeah, it has a range. So for this case, we are taking 7850 kgs per meter cubic. Now, for us to be able to get the quantity of steel, we are taking the volume and then we multiply by the density. So the volume of steel is 0.036, and then the density is 780 kgs per meter cubic. So if we tabulate that 0.036 by 7850, we get 282.6 kgs. So those are the kgs that we need in a slab that is 6 meters long, 4 meters wide, and 0.15 meters deep. So that is the quantity of steel that we need. Now, if you proceed, we had said this is an estimation for the slab, the beam, the column, and the footing. So when you want to proceed, you just use the same procedure. If it's the beam, get the volume of concrete of that beam. That is the length, the width, and the depth. And then proceed to getting the volume of steel, and then proceed to getting the quantity of steel for in that beam. And then if it's the column, you also repeat the same procedure, and also the same procedure applies to the footing. So guys, that is how we estimate the quantity of steel using the thumb rule. And remember, we said the thumb rule is it gives us approximate values. So there's a range that maybe we should not exceed, but at least we have a very quick solution to finding the quantity of steel when we really need it very, very fast. So thank you guys for your time. Thank you for your support. Subscribe, share. Don't forget to leave a comment. Until next time, bye-bye.